Hello everyone. Welcome to Equity Masters Stock Market Wrap Up. This is Rini Mehta, and in today's podcast, I'll be talking about stocks, economy, and everything that matters to your wealth creation. Later in the podcast, I'll reveal an amazing offer to build wealth that is hard to imagine. It is the secret to invest in good companies before they turn big. So stay tuned. Now let's look at the key stories that I will cover today. Rupee stages comeback as government mulls taking measures. India's inflation and industrial production data amid rupee slide and rising petrol prices. Global stocks amid US-China trade talks. HCL Technologies share buyback plans. Domestic passenger vehicle sales gain traction, and top sectors and companies that swayed the markets this week. First, a quick look at broader cues. Reversing a two-day meltdown, Indian stock market staged a smart pullback towards the end of the week as investors scooped up recently hammered FMCG metal and capital goods stocks amid a recovery in the rupee. The Indian rupee rallied the most in 1.5 years, and stocks recovered on the reports that the government may announce measures to support the currency after a planned review of the economy by Prime Minister Narendra Modi this weekend. The rupee strengthened after a new low of 72.91 after this announcement came in. The Sensex too rebounded and benchmark 10-year bond yields dropped 5 basis points to 8.13%. Note that the rupee has slid 12% this year in Asia's worst performance, and the losses have begun to hurt sentiment in the nation's stock and bond markets as well. The Sensex tumbled 2.5% in 2 days to Tuesday this week, the most since February, and the benchmark yield rose to 8.23%, the highest since November 2014. The sell-off has come amid surging oil prices, which is India's biggest pain point and threatens to stoke inflation, worsen the government's finances, and impinge on companies' borrowing costs. That aggravates a negative spiral for the economy. Moreover, global funds have pulled around $733 million from local bonds so far in September and $133 million from shares this week. The currency's persistent weakness has prompted authorities to ask central bank to intervene more aggressively to stem the slide. Given we are in an election year, it will be interesting to see how government responds to these economic shocks and how market participants react in the stock markets. Coming to the news from the oil space, global oil supply hit a record high last month. As per the Energy Information Administration, production around the world hit 100 million barrels a day for the first time in August, despite falling output in several OPEC member countries. Crude prices slipped nearly 3% following the report. With the petrol and diesel prices hitting new all-time highs, you surely must be feeling the pinch. You can listen to our previous episode wherein Sarvajit Bodas, research analyst at Equity Master, offers insights into what's moving fuel prices and where they can go from here. So don't miss it. Amid the very negative environment surrounding the rupee and petrol prices, the latest releases on CPI inflation and IIP growth came as a relief. Investors cheered as the industrial production grew at 6.6% in July on the back of good performance by the manufacturing sector and higher offtake of capital goods and consumer durables. Meanwhile, CPI inflation dipped 3.7% in August compared to 4.2% in July. Note that CPI fell below 4% for the first time in 2018 as prices of vegetables and pulses remained in check even as fuel prices rose. The lower than expected inflation reading complicates the task for India's Monetary Policy Committee, which may see the need to hike rates in response to a weaker rupee when it meets next in October. Now coming to the global news, stocks jumped on Thursday following a lower than expected US inflation reading and optimism that US and China could avoid further escalation in trade war that has put nearly all products shipped between the two countries at risk of facing import taxes. Senior US officials invited Chinese counterparts to sit down for trade talks before the US follows through with proposed tariffs on roughly 200 billion US dollar worth of Chinese products. Meanwhile, a surprisingly sharp interest rate hike in crisis hit Turkey supported the lira and global risk appetite. From the stock-specific activities this week, HCL Technologies was in focus as the company said that its proposed 40 billion rupees share buyback will kick off on 18 September. As per the announcement, the buyback will be done on a proportionate basis through tender offer route at ₹1,100 apiece. Speaking of buybacks, the number of buyback offers in 2017 and 18 were at an all-time high. Never in the last two decades had Indian markets seen 59 companies announcing buyback plans. But what is truly surprising is that unlike in the past, the buybacks this time seem skewed in the favor of short-term investors rather than long-term ones. As per Rahul Shah, co-head of research at Equity Master, investors should not assume buybacks are always good. As Rahul says, and I quote, "The reason behind the buyback must be investigated. At the end of the day, an increase in earnings should be more a function of the inherent robustness of the business, as that's what will help it continue to grow at a healthy pace." Unquote. Moving on to the news from the automobile sector, domestic passenger vehicle sales for August witnessed a drop as sales fell due to ongoing floods in various parts of the country. Domestic passenger vehicle sales were down by 2.3% in August as compared to the same period a year ago. Car sales were down 1% in August, while two-wheeler sales grew by almost 3%. Motorcycle sales were up by 6.2% on the back of a positive monsoon for most parts of India. Commercial vehicles too outperformed as sales jumped by 30% in August as compared to the same period a year ago. Going forward, it will be interesting to see if vehicle sales are able to continue the robust growth rate considering growing crude prices which ultimately affect buyer decision. Pharma stocks were in action this week. Shares of Sun Pharma were trading lower in the beginning of the week as the company on Tuesday said the US health regulator is conducting an inspection of its Mohali facility in Punjab. The inspection of US FDA started on September 10th. Note that last week, the US FDA had issued Form 483 with 6 observations after an inspection of the company's Halol facility in Gujarat. However, the stock rebounded after the company said that it has received US FDA approval for Zelpros. The drug is used to treat ocular hypertension. Other pharma stocks such as Cipla and Cadila Healthcare were also in news. Cipla's South African subsidiary received approval from the country's health regulator for the latest first-line triple combination antiretroviral treatment for HIV. While Zydus Cadila received tentative approval from the US FDA to market tablets indicated for treating diabetes in the American market. Now coming to the offer I was talking about, with markets throwing up a lot of opportunities, dear listeners, you could build wealth that is hard to imagine with Richa Agarwal, the single most brilliant small cap analyst and her recommendations. It contains stock ideas that could beat the Sensex three times over. Just log on to hiddentreasure.in/discover to discover small caps of your own. I repeat, hiddentreasure.in/discover. Do not miss this. It could make a world of difference to your wealth. Well, that's all from us today. Now, before I sign off, we would like to know whether you like our idea of podcast. Is there anything specific that you would want us to cover? We would love your feedback. Just visit equitymaster.com and drop us a line. We look forward to hearing from you. Thank you and happy investing.